A warm welcome to each and everyone. It's me, Gayatri. This year also, I'm going to continue as your IT teacher. Hope all are doing well. So there is no need of a special introduction. Let me start this academic year IT portions. Hope all of you got your test book. So let's start our portions. So the first chapter we are going to start is Know Your Computer. This is the first chapter of this class. That is, now you are in 7th standard. The first chapter is Know Your Computer. I know you have some knowledge about computer. This year we are going to know something else. Okay, before that, let me give you an introduction. In today's world, everything become fast. In the case of communication, in the case of traveling, everything become busy. We are also busy. Then we are searching for what? The technology that would help us to make our lives so easy. Yes or no? Yes. So we depend upon the technology for our day-to-day life. If we have a better computer network, it will help us for our fastest communication. So this chapter we are going to introduce about computer networks and the advantages of computer network. Also, we will study about the advantages and disadvantages of computer network. So let's start this chapter now. So the first topic is the first topic of this chapter is computer network. A computer network means it is an interconnection of more than two computers and some hardware devices through a communication channel. Computer network means an interconnection of more than two computers and some hardware devices. You know what is a hardware device? So we are interconnecting computers and hardware devices through a communication channel. Then there comes computer network. So what is the purpose, main purpose of computer network? The main purpose is to facilitate communication. Not only to facilitate communication, also for sharing resources. So a new word comes there is resources. What you meant by resources? It include hardware and software. So the main purpose of computer network are to facilitate an easy communication or a fastest communication, and also to share resources. Resources includes hardware and software. We can share hardware and software through computer network. Not only hardware and software, we can send data files and so many. So once again, a computer network means it's an interconnection of more than two computers and some hardware devices through a communication channel. And the main purpose is to facilitate a better communication and also to share resources. Now we can discuss about the advantages of computer network. In your textbook, page number 2, there are 7 advantages given. The first one is speed. The first advantage of computer network is speed. From the word itself, you know the meaning. Speed means what? We can share our data files and resources very fast. Rapidly we can share our data files. That means what? We can save our time. So this is the first advantage of computer network is speed. Now the second one is communication. The second one is what? Communication. Computer network help us to facilitate a better communication. For that, computer network offers us so many services, just like email, instant messaging. So many services are there to help us to communicate with others using what? Computer network. So you got the first and second advantages of computer network. Now the third one. What is the third one? Information sharing. The third one is what? Information sharing. For example, now you are getting an information about this IT first chapter from YouTube, yes or no? That means I'm sharing an information to you. That is what? Information sharing. We can share our information, what information we have, we can share to others using what? Computer network. This is the third point or third advantage of computer network. Now the fourth one. Third one is resource sharing. The beginning I told you that what a resource is. Resources may include hardware or software or data files. For an example, here I can give you an example. That means in an office, if there are 10 users is using a computer, 10 users. So that means that 10 of them want to do more work in the computer. Sometimes they want to take printouts, sometimes they want to send the prints, so many work will be there. So it's necessary for them to have 10 printers in that office. Is it necessary? No. If there is a better computer network, what happens if there is a better computer network? No need of 10 printers, only one printer is needed. Using that one printer, we can connect, that one printer can be connected to all the computers in that office. Using what? Using computer network. So just listen, if we have an active computer network, we can share our resources efficiently. That means, for example, in the case of printer, no need of how many users are there, that much printer is not at all needed. Only one printer is needed, and using this computer network we can connect this printer to all the computers. So it's very helpful for us to use computer network in the case of resources. Now the next point is preserve information. Preserve information means we can refresh our data and transfer this data to a new media. That means we can keep a backup copy. What do you mean by backup copy? We can take one more copies of our data and keep it into another media. That is preserve information. So it is very helpful. The chance of losing data will not be there. Once again, preserve information means we can refresh our data and transfer this data to another media. That means we can keep a backup copy of our data. Now the next point is what? Cost effective. The sixth point is cost effective. The sixth advantage of computer network is cost effective. That means what? Yes, it's very cost. We can save our cost. How? If we are having this resource sharing and all, we can save our cost using computer network. That is the sixth point. Now the last advantage is reliability. The last advantage of computer network is reliability. Reliability means if we are having the situation to take the backup copies of our data using computer network, that means the chance of losing data will not be there. That means if anything happens to our computer, there is a backup copy of our data. So it is also an best advantage of computer network. So once again we can discuss, there are seven advantages for computer network. The first one is speed. That means what? We can share our data rapidly to the others. That means we can save our time. This is the first advantage of computer network. So using computer network we can save our time. The second advantage is communication. Communication means computer network facilitate a better communication through so many services, just like email, instant messaging. That means we can share or we can communicate with others who are far away. Within seconds, we can share our emotions. Everything we can do using computer network. And the third point is information sharing. We can share the information what all we have through computer network, just like now we are doing. That means now we are sharing the information about the first chapter through YouTube. That means through computer network. That means we are sharing our information. Now the fourth point is resource sharing. Resource sharing means we can share hardware through computer network. For example, in the case of printer, no need of so many hardwares. If there is an active computer network, we can share our resources. And the fifth point is preserve information. That means we can store our data in other media. That means we can keep a backup copy. The sixth advantage is cost effective. If we have a better computer network, we can reduce the cost also. That means what? If we have a better computer network, we can share our network. So we can save our cost. And the last advantage is reliability. Reliability means if there is an option to have backup copies, that means the chance of losing data will not be there. So we can save our data. So these are the seven advantages of computer network. So once again, let me say computer network means interconnection of two or more computers and some hardware devices through a communication channel. Then what happens? We will get a computer network. The main purpose is to facilitate easy communication and for sharing resources. After that, we have discussed seven advantages of computer network: speed, communication, information sharing, resource sharing, preserve information, cost effective, and at last, reliability. So hope all of you understood the definition about computer network and the seven advantages of computer network. So just take your textbook, page number 1 and 2, read the steps. For the next class, just make it thorough. If you have any doubt, let me know. Thank you.